nanoHUB-U, online instruction.
Hey everyone, welcome to lecture 3.7. So now we're continuing on the topic of photovoltaic light trapping by looking more at tandem photovoltaic cells in finite difference time domain. And so what is our basic method of characterizing experimental data in finite difference time domain? So one of the key things that we can do, I'll explain in more detail later, is actually capture fractional absorption of certain layers in finite difference time domain, which allows us to tell if a layer is having parasitic optical absorption or not. And so that basically is something we can quantify. And then we can compare that then to experimental data on solar cells, which oftentimes would be stuff like external quantum efficiency, total absorption, and reflection. So that goes back to what I showed you earlier with the literature. And then that combination of information allows you to then extract the charge transport loss in the system, or another way to put it is the so-called absorber light harvesting efficiency, which is different from the internal quantum efficiency because it takes out the parasitic absorption effects that oftentimes would degrade internal quantum efficiency. So it's a more optimistic measure, if you will, of the, you know, the best case potential of that absorber material to basically harvest light as electricity. And so how do we actually capture the parasitic absorption of the different components in the optical system? Here, I'm just showing an example of what if you had a textured structure on the top of the system, and then the back you actually had like a silver nanoparticle array that was on top of like a flat silver back reflector. And so here you can see, of course, that we could typically take flux planes on the top and bottom of this photovoltaic cell, and we could calculate the overall absorption and reflection, which is a relatively well-known approach, where basically we calculate the pointing vector at each of these surface plaquettes, if you will, and then we integrate over that surface. And we can do that at multiple frequencies or just a single frequency, integrate over all frequencies. However, if we have a more complex absorber region and we really need to track absorption in that volume, then we can have this volume integration. But there is a problem, which is that this is very slow. So this generally scales as n cubed if n is the size of the problem. So that actually slows down our whole simulation dramatically if the volume is not extremely small. Okay, so it doesn't even have to be that large of a fraction of the total volume. But our approach now is actually using a flexible flux plane method in which we would kind of get the best of both worlds, one of which is to have like that surface integration feature, but also to have it flexible enough so that it can exactly go around the contours of the boundaries, which are not flat in the system, and then allow you to, for example, look at the absorption just of this yellow layer, perovskite, by putting flexible flux planes around both boundaries. And then, of course, you know from basic vector calculus that you can convert the volume integral into a surface integral. And so that is much faster, in fact, if done properly with the flexible flux plane method. So that allows you to do much larger PV volume, and the computational time is still reasonable. And so just looking at an example of the efficiency associated with tandem cells. So here's like basically a textured surface, and then looking at like what is the efficiency of amorphous silicon crystalline silicon tandem, we're able to actually design the texturing so that we have very strong current match. Like both the amorphous and crystalline silicon have JSC about 12.8 milliamps per square centimeters. And then the texture height and correlation factors are given here. And so that actually tells us like what are the optimal conditions for making a good tandem cell. And then this actually shows like what would be the light absorption in both the amorphous silicon and crystalline silicon layer, and then what's the total absorption of the overall device that you can measure like externally in experiment. In the next lecture, we'll talk about more details of perovskite silicon tandems.